So m, so what is in the middle? We have m squared minus 25. Then we can continue to factorize m plus 5, m minus 5 equals to 0. Okay, so what are our options now? Such that this is equals to 0. Something times something times something equals to 0. So any one of those could be equals to 0, right? So there are three options. 2m equals to 0, or m plus 5 equals to 0, or m minus 5 equals to 0. So from here, I will get three options. Oh, so what method did you do?
Like
m squared equals to 25. Okay, hang on.
2m is
25. Ah, okay, yes. All of you did the same thing. Like what Yipin said also, please return the papers back. And I will explain now why it doesn't, what issue is there with that. Yeah, that's why this is not correct lah. Okay, so why, now based on these answers, right? If I substitute m equals to 5 into the original equation, is this satisfied? Yes, of course it is. If I substitute negative 5 into the original equation, is the equation satisfied? Yes, it is. If I substitute 0 into the equation, is it satisfied? Yes, it is. There are three answers. So what happened to your answer 0? This is what you did. So in red, this is incorrect. 2m cubed equals to 50m. Okay, you divide by 2 first, no problem, equals to 25m. But now, what did you do? Divide by m, right? This is what you did. And you get m squared equals to 25. What's the issue with this?
Nothing.
There is a problem.
Right.
I'm really telling you that m could be equals to 0, right? The very act of you dividing by m, it could be dividing by 0. See, over here you divide by m, right? M could have been 5, it could have been negative 5, it could have been 0. So if you divide it this way, you are assuming that m is not equal to 0 already. You try divide by 0, what do you get? Yeah, no, if you divide by 0, you get an error. Well, after now you tell me divide by 0 is not an error. Okay, so don't go and divide unnecessarily. Dividing by 2 initially was okay, right? See, I divide by 2 over here, it is fine. No problem, because I will definitely not get an error. The problem comes in the next step when I divide by m. I'm telling you, this is an error. It shouldn't have happened this way. There should have been 3 blanks or just 1 big blank. Okay, question 2. 7. And 40. Need me to go through? Yeah, mark, please. Anybody needs me to go through, raise out a hand? I said raise out a hand, I didn't say if you don't need, then you skip. Right? Question 3. 0, 3. And negative 5 over 2. Yes, it's the same as negative 2.5. Anybody needs me to go through? Okay, let's move quickly. Question 4, 180. Anybody needs me to go through? Very interesting question, right? So disappointing. 5a, this is 5, and negative 3. Don't care the lightning. Which one? Okay, 5. We have 2 power p times 7 is 2, 4. 2 to 4 over here is equals to, divide by 2, you get 1, 2. Divide by 2 again, you get 56. 2. Hang on, 2 to the power of p. So, 2 to 4 is equals to 2 to the power 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times 7. Do you see the answer now? Then we compare. This, 7, 2 power p. So p is equal to 5. Okay. Then how do you do it? Oh, okay. Or, 224 divided by 7 is equals to 32, right? Then 32 equals to 2 to the power 5, so E equals to 5. Same. Now part B. One over 125 is equals to 5 to the power k. If you did your, if you remember your logarithms, you can solve it that way, but if you don't, then we can compare powers. Here we have 1 over 5 power 3. It's equals to 5 power k. Therefore, 5 power negative 3 equals to 5 power k, and k equals to negative 3. You're not learning it, so don't confuse yourself. Then you go and try lah. Okay, can I move on? Okay, now, total surface area of this solid, it is 31 pi r squared. Yeah, 31 pi r squared. Anybody needs me to go through? Raise your hand. CN, you need? Okay. Total surface area is made out of? Made out of one curved surface area over here. Let's find out what that is first. This is actually a hemisphere. So it is half of a sphere. The area, curved area of hemisphere is equal to half times the area of an entire sphere, right? So 4 pi times the radius. What is the radius now of this hemisphere? 3 r. This is for the hemisphere, okay? Then, now I want to consider the curved surface area of this cylinder. Curve area of cylinder is equals to pi. No? Oh, sorry. 4 pi r square. Yeah. This one is square. Sorry, careless mistake. I didn't forget. Okay, then over here, curved surface area of the cylinder is pi r square times the height, which is 2 r. No, sorry. 2 pi r times 2 r. Okay, curved surface area of the cylinder. And then now, I have one more portion, right? The flat parts. So I can choose to find out this area first. Then I find out this area and I add them up. Or I can notice that, the small green part and the big green part, they all add up to be one big flat circle. So the area of flat surface is equals to pi times 3 r square. Then we add all 3 r. Okay, next. Question 7, this is 4.8 times 10 to the power 7, 9.3 times 10 to the power 6, and 4.25 times 10 to the power 8. For Vietnam? 7. Yeah, it's not printed very well. Okay, now we go on to the set question, Venn diagrams. Based on this diagram, we are supposed to fill in all these things. Q. Okay, you didn't get the answer. Q intersect R is equal to, what is this? Empty set, null set. That means there is nothing. So if I take Q intersect with R, Q is here, R is here, they do not intersect, right? So their intersection is null. Not applicable. No such thing. Okay? What about E and R? What is this E over here? The E sign? Yes, it is an element. Okay? This little E over here is not a set. There is no circle for it. It is just an element. So E is an element of R. Okay, yes. P union Q is equals to P. Because P over here, then I union with Q is still the set P. Yep, Q is a subset of P. In fact, it is a proper subset. I'm sorry, wait. Proper subset is this. This is a proper subset. Proper subset means that they are not equal. Okay? Any questions on subset and proper subset? Gwen, make sure you know the difference between this versus this. You can think of it as this versus this. What do I mean by equal? You know, when I say, for example, let's use something that we are familiar with. When I say that x is smaller than 5, can x be equal to 5? Cannot. When I say x is smaller than or equals to 5, can x be equals to 5? Can. Okay, so similarly for this, if I say that a is a subs is this thing of b, can a be equal to b? Cannot. So we call this a proper subset. Now, if I say C and this symbol D, can C be equal to D? Yes, can. Can C be also a part of D? Also can. So we call this a subset. All the elements in C definitely must be elements of D. Likewise for this, all the elements of A definitely must be all the elements of B. Q is a proper subset. It is proper because there is no equal. Okay? 9A. If you still need clarification, you don't want to hold the rest up, then you can come and look for me. 9A. Completing a square, standard type of question, x plus 6, square minus 43. You full marks here, your exam got full marks. The minimum value will be negative 43. Okay, when? When is the... No, they are asking for the minimum value of this. Value of this. What is this equal to? They are not asking you for the x value. They are asking you for the answer. Okay, now, I have a question. When is the minimum value equals to negative 43? When? Does it happen? Yeah, it's at the minimum point. What is the value of x? What is the corresponding of value of x such that you get the answer as negative 43? X equals to? X equals to negative 6. Because if you look at your completed square, when x is equals to negative 6, negative 6 plus 6 equals to 0. So 0 square is 0. That is the smallest value, 0. The smallest value for something square. Okay? So since 0 is the smallest value, therefore 0 minus 43 will give you negative 43. Yeah? Now, what is the line of symmetry for the graph y equals to x squared, blah, 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 blah? So, answer is negative 6. Yes? What's wrong, Winston? Yep. We need to write x equals 2. Because if you don't write x equals 2, then it becomes a number only. It is not an equation. It is not a line. Okay, so just remember, make sure you write the x. X equals 2. Okay, now sketch the graph. Okay, not symmetrical, I don't like. It looks better. I bet it looks better than yours. Yeah, I'm sorry. Okay, something like that, okay? Now over here. Oh, this is still not very good. Because I know that it will pass through negative 7, and the minimum point is negative 43. So, where it intersects? Okay, like that. Ah.
So your curve went out of the ground.
Never mind, like, a bit only. Okay. Now over here, this is negative 7. This is negative 43. And my line of symmetry over here, this value is negative 6. So the minimum point will be negative 6, negative 43. They only wanted the x, the y-intercept and the turning point, so I don't need to find the x-intercepts. If the question didn't say, then please go and find out what the x-intercepts are. And of course, label y equals to x squared plus 12x minus 7.
Wow.
This is very, oh, okay. Why are you all so amused by this kind of thing? Y equals to x squared plus 12x minus 7. Okay? Yeah, I cannot erase. Okay, next. Coordinates over here will be negative 2, comma 2. And for your vector representing AC, negative 3, 6. Then next one is 6.71. Okay, so judging from all the let's go through a bit. There's Euling also. Okay, coordinates of point C. Before I start on this question, I can write down my vector OA, isn't it? In the column vector form, what is this equal to? 1, negative 4. Then OB will be negative 7, negative 2. Coordinates of point OC. I need to find out what is OC first. And this is equals to, I have BC, right? So OB plus BC equals to negative 7, negative 2 plus 5, 4. Answer is negative 2 and 2. These are not coordinates. This is the column vector for OC. So I need one more step. C is negative 2, comma 2. Any other way that you presented that you want to clarify? Okay, then for one mark, it's still okay. Okay, part B, column vector representing AC. So AC is equals to AO plus OC, yes? What is AO? It is actually negative OA lah, plus OC, and negative OA will be negative over here, 1, negative 4, plus OC, which is negative 2, 2. Answer is negative 3, 6 lah. Anybody needs B to go through the magnitude? No need ah? Okay, 11. 11 A, we have 13. 2 times 3 times 5 square. 7, 6. Anything you need me to go through? If not, part C. Okay, there are many, many answers that we can accept for this. Very hard for me to write out all the range, but I'll show you how to answer this question. Okay, can I move on? LCM of x and y is blah, blah, blah. HCF of x and y is 2 times 3. So we know that x is going to be equal to something times something times something. I don't know how many times. Likewise, for y, we have the something similar. Don't know how many times. But based on the HCF, if the HCF is 2 times 3, it tells me that I can therefore know that x has at least one factor of 2 and 1 factor of 3. Okay, this is one possibility. Definitely, x must have a factor of 2 and 3, and it is at least one of them. I can also say the same thing for y. Y, everything is the same. So I know that both x and y, they minimum have 2 as a factor, they minimum have 3 as a factor. Okay, so far? HCF, Now LCM. LCM of x and y equals to 5 times 2 squared times 3 power 4. So what this means is that, therefore, x has maximum of 1 factor, 5. It has maximum 2 factors of 2, meaning the 2 square. And at most, it has 4 times of 3. Can you understand so far? At most, it can only have 4 times of 3, meaning 3 times 3 times 3 times 3. That's the maximum. Cannot go beyond that, really. It has a maximum of 2 times 2. Cannot have 2 times 2 times 2. Maximum is only 2 times 2. Likewise, maximum 5, it only appears one time. Okay? And I can say the same thing for y. Everything else is the same. So between these two, I can write down my values of x and y. There are many, many possibilities. Hang on. I know x and y, they both have a minimum of 2 times 3. So 2 times 3 over here, 2 times 3. This is the minimum. Right? Then we have settled the HCF already. Now we tackle the LCM. For x, maximum 1 factor of 5, right? So let's assign the 5 to it. Okay? And it has maximum 2 factors of 2. Right now, how many factors does it have of 2? Only 1. It can go up to how many? 2. Okay, let's give it the 2. Let's give all the 2s to x. What about factors 3? What is the maximum that it can have? It can have maximum 4, right? Let's give it everything. So this is one possibility. So if we consider these two now. Y now. Y has a maximum 1 factor of 5, right? Y has maximum 1 factor of 5. So can it have no 5s at all? It is possible, right? We say maximum it has 1. But it is also possible that it has none. So for me, I choose to not give it any 5. But I can choose to give it 5 also. Up to you, it's fine. So that's why there are many possible answers. Y has a maximum of 2 factors of 2. Currently it has 1 of it. Can I leave it as 1? Sure. Can I change it to 2? Not really. Because if I change it to 2, then my HCF will have to change. Similarly for factor 3. Right now, I say that it has maximum of 4 of them, right? Can I leave it as 1? Sure, I can. So now, let's check our answers. For these two numbers, x and y, what is the HCF? 2 times 3. We take out whatever is common. Nothing more, nothing less. We take out whatever is common. So 2 times 3, that is my HCF. What is the LCM? LCM, we take the union of all the factors. So what is the union of 2 and 2 squared? 2 squared. What is the union of 3 and 3 power 4? 3 power 4. What is the union of 5 and 1? 5. So the LCM is now 5 times 2 squared times 3 to the power 4. So what other possible answers could there be? We could also have x equals to 2 times 3 times 5. By the way, you need to tell me what's the value. And also can have y equals to 2 squared times 3 power 4. This is possible. I can also have x is equals to 2 squared times 3 times 5. Y equals to 2 times 3 power 4. Many possible answers. Regardless of what you choose, you go and check back your work. Whether you will still get the same HCF and the same LCM. Any questions?
No.
Okay, then question 13. 13A, answer is 58.80. So 2DP because we are dealing with dollars. Next one, 3.744. What do you get? Anybody needs me to go through? No, okay. Then 14A. 14A is 4.25. Anybody needs me to go through? Yes, huh? Okay. This is a regular pentagon. By telling you it is regular, we know that all the interior angles are the same. We know that all the sides are 5 cm. Okay, then what is one interior angle anyway? Okay, now why? Find the length of OA. So over here, I can draw a right angle triangle. Can you see? Okay, let me use another color. Draw one perpendicular line down. And this is 2.5. Here we also have 2.5. I want to find the length of OA. So the highlighted part. Wow, very big. Okay, I want to find this. I am going to draw out this right angle triangle. Over here. 2.5. This is O and A. I want to find this. I can find this angle. Because once I get this angle, I can use my trigonometric ratio opposite hypotenuse. So I use sine of this angle is equal to 2.5 divided by my unknown. So now the challenge is to find this angle. This angle over here. Okay? This angle is half of this angle, right? Okay? Can follow so far? This red angle is half of the green angle. So I need to find out the green angle. I use symmetry. Let me join up all of this. So this green angle is the same over here. So what is one green angle? Green angle will be 360 divided by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? So the green angle, let us call it, let's give this point a name. Let's call it B. Okay, so angle BOA is equal to 360 degrees divided by 5. And that gives me 72 degrees. Yes, that's one green angle. And the red angle over here is just half of the green angle. So this one over here is 72 degrees divided by 2. And we get 36 degrees. Okay? Therefore, using sine 36 degrees equals to opposite 2.5 divided by OA. And OA is equals to something, you round it off to 4.25. Okay? So OA, we have it as 4.253. By symmetry, all of these, all the blue lines, they're all 4.253, right? All the blue lines are 4.253. Then, to find the area of the shaded triangle, I will divide this shaded triangle into three triangles. The first one is over here. Then I can find the area of this triangle. It is half times 4.253 times 4.253 times sine of 72 degrees. Can follow so far? Of this blue triangle. Half times 4.253 times 4.253 times sine 72 degrees. Okay, so area equals to half 4.253 sine 72 degrees plus, now I need this triangle. This orange one, isn't it the same as this orange one? Yes, right. And what is the area of this orange triangle? Half AB sine C again. This side over here, this side has the same length as this. It also has the same length as this of 4.253. Okay? Same, all same. So plus the orange one, which is half 4.253 times 4.253 times sine, the angle over here. What is this angle? It is, yeah, 144. Because 72 times 2. Originally, when I didn't shade, I had one blue line. This was 72, this is 72. So add them together, you get 144. So this is one orange triangle. I need to multiply it by 2 to get two orange triangles. Okay, then this will give you the answer as 19.2 approximately. Okay, okay. Okay, part B. Oh, anybody managed to get this? Answer is 1620. Who got it? You got it? Got it? Got it? So what is the trick to this? We need to consider, there may be more than one way, but how I did it is, I considered the sum of angles at a point. So I have many, many points over here. So what is the sum of angles at this point? 360. Sum of angle at this point? 360, 360, 360, 360, 360, 360. Okay, so what's the point of doing all that? Let me just count for some. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Sum of angles equals to 7 times of 360, right? But now I have a lot of extra angles if I were to just add them up. Where are my extra angles? They are here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As well as 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I just want A plus B plus C, D, E, F, G, I need to take everything, I need to minus away the red ones. Okay, so what is the sum of the red angles? Five-sided figure. So 5 minus 3 times 180. Then I still need to minus away the green ones, which is 4 minus 2 times 180 degrees. And your final answer will be 1620 lah. Sorry? Why is it 5 minus 3? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lah? Oh, sorry, minus 2. Yeah. Thank you. Minus 2 times 180. Anybody did it any other way? What do you use? Okay. Once again, also the same. Yeah, thanks. Here's an alternative. If you're interested, go and ask him for it. Okay, moving on. 15A, x is greater than half. Part B. Oh no, I can't see the answer. Okay, let me work this out. Simplify this. x cubed over y squared divided by 3xy power negative 1 squared over 1. Yes? Same, right? Okay, so dividing, I flip. I change it to a multiply. Equals to 15x cubed over y squared multiplied by 1 over entire thing. X, Y, power negative 1, square. Okay? Then now, I can cancel. 15 and 3. This becomes 1, this becomes 5. Let me simplify further. I'm left with 5x cubed over y squared, x squared, y power negative 2. Right? Any questions so far? Okay, then 5x cubed over x squared. Oh, y squared times y power negative 2, what's that? Y power 0. Okay, so y power 2 minus 2. Now that gives me 1. So this is equals to 5x. Do you all get this? All got this? Okay, let me write it bigger. 5x. If no questions, I will continue. Factorize completely, you get p minus 2, q minus 4. Right now, two simultaneous equations. Okay, since they are parallel lines, then the interior angles are supplementary, meaning interior angles, they will add up to be 180 degrees. First equation will be 3y minus 20 plus 2x plus 5 equals 180. And then we simplify. Simplify it to get 3y plus 2x equals to, so minus 15 plus 15, 195. Okay? That is this one equation. The other equation is 4x plus 5 plus x plus y minus 20 equals to 180. So I get 5x plus y, then equals to 195 again. So these are my two equations. Solving them, we will get x equals to 30, y equals to 45. Do you get the same answer? Let me see. That means you didn't simplify now. Two x plus 3y is, oh, you didn't simplify. Oh, okay. Can. Also can. One alternative to the one third equation that you could have written is you add all of them up. Angle sum is equals to 360. That is a third equation you could form. And solving will still give you the same answer. Oh. Ah, okay. So x is 30, y is 145, so the obtuse angles will be 115. As well as 125. Okay? Just substitute them back into the this one over here and this one, obtuse angles. Okay, wait. What is the size of obtuse angles? So many obtuse, oh no, this one. This one and this one, obtuse angles. So they are 115 and 125. Yes? They already have the degree for you, right? Yeah? For degree already. Simultaneous equation. If you put, you put for everything. If you don't put, if you don't want to, you don't have to. So you put over here, is it? Then the rest, do you put? I mean, do you put degrees over here also? Then you should lah. So that's why I didn't write in the first place. If you don't write, it's still okay. But if you write for everything lah. Okay? 17a, oral is equals to 1 over 5d squared. Anybody needs me to go through? Anjali. Ikpin. 你没有说吗? Part 2, 0.05. Okay? And then the diagram will be number 2. Question 18, 45.8, 22.32, and 46.4. 2.32 radian. Did you leave your answer in degree? Oh, okay, okay. Say wrongly. All okay for this question? Cut A in another method. Okay, come, I will go through this. Length of AB, right? Over here, this diagram, it is made out of two triangles and a circle. These triangles are right angle triangles. I'll tell you know already. So you use Pythagoras lah, to find the length of AB. There are other ways to do it for part A, but the shortest way is to use Pythagoras. Question 19, 050. Why? You all didn't get it? Okay. I don't know how accurate you are, I don't know how accurate the printing is, but what we should do is to join it up. Then we find this angle. 050 degrees. Is this how you did it, Yuling? Then if yours shows as 40 degrees, then so be it. Next, Alan Q. You change the scale. Oh, yeah, okay, because they printed smaller for you, all right. You draw the exact thing on piece of foolscap, is it? Oh, draw over the words, huh? Then your answer will be different from mine already lah. But anyway, let's just go through the concept, okay? Now, the change direction sails 50 kilometers bearing 170 degrees to the lighthouse. Aura, oh okay. So, now it sails in this direction and this angle will be 170 degrees. How long do we draw this? Draw very, very long first. Then, we want 50 kilometers, right? 50 kilometers, you find the correct scale, shrink it down to the correct value in centimeters, then you use your compasses, draw an arc for 50 kilometers. What? Or you just use your ruler to measure, is it? Okay, now I'm telling you the standard way of doing it, you're supposed to draw an arc. So everything? Yeah, everything is just arc on. Yeah. Okay, then once we have that, I will have my point aura. So what is the bearing of the lighthouse aura from port P? So join it up and find this angle, whatever is your drawing, okay? Because you are using different scales. Some of you adjusted the scale, some of you didn't care, just use the scale that they asked you to do so. Fine, no problem. As long as you follow the concept, your answer is okay. All right, then, according to this question paper, they say it's 125 lah. Now the average speed of the ferry is 35 kilometers per hour. Calculate the time taken to travel to the lighthouse. So time taken, we have our pyramid, distance, speed and time. To find the time, we take distance divided by speed. Distance, you go and measure, how much is this? You add that to this, then we divide it by 35. Since we already had different answers for part C, you are going to have different answers for part C, part 2 as well. In mine, it is 2 hours and 34 minutes. Okay? Questions? Now 20, fill in the blanks. 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 9. Okay? Kind of like number patterns lah. Anybody needs to go through? 1 over 12 and 5 over 18? If you need, raise your hand. The most likely number of spaces is 7. Number 7, because it has the most number of possible outcomes. All the rest are less, are fewer. (21, 68.78, 44, 3/8). Oh, 44.375, yeah, it's the same. And the final one is 1.55. Ken? Sorry? Improper fraction. Okay lah, Ken. But just change it to mix lah. Because they're asking you for liters, ma. If you're asking for liters, I want to know like how many liters. I mean, if you leave it as an improper, right, it's very hard for me to gauge how many liters that is, right? 22. 15. 60. Okay, now for this one, yes? Yeah, it's supposed to be a smooth curve. Okay, what are the points first? At time equals to 20, what is the distance? 150. 20 and 150, this is 1 point. Another point will be, at time equals to 50, total distance will be 600. 50 and 600. Which part is going to be a straight line? Which one is a straight line? There are three parts to this. One part is supposed to be a smooth, straight line. See, this is a speed-time graph given. When the speed is constant, that tells you that the distance is increasing at a constant rate. And the gradient of a distance-time graph gives you a speed, right? So if the speed is constant, it implies that gradient of distance time graph is constant, meaning it is a straight line. Okay, here we have the speed is increasing, so gradient of dt graph is increasing, meaning it gets steeper. And finally, for this one, the gradient of dt graph is decreasing, meaning it gets gentler. Can understand? Okay, then we convert all of this into our graph. The straight line is in the middle. So use a ruler, draw a straight line. Then now, from 0 to 20, it is supposed to be a curve. And we know that the gradient is increasing. Okay? It is a curve, gradient is increasing. So it looks like this lah. This type of curve, gradient increasing. So curve up. From here, if I want to have a smooth one, I follow the gradient. Then I go down. From here, not very nice. Okay, like this. So smooth, huh? Then now, for time equals to 50 to time equals to t, I need a curve again. This time, it is getting gentler. The gradient is decreasing. So over here, I follow the gradient first, then I slope. Okay, this is my final graph. Any questions? Okay, 24 2/3. 12.1. This one is your calculator skills lah. For this, you need to show your working. SD equals to all the square root and whatever not inside, okay? Part 1. No. 24.7 is you rounded off already. Huh? Because initially it was 24.666666, right? Then you rounded off. Then it's not accurate anymore. So we use the most exact version. Now part B. Okay, part B. Time measured incorrectly, all 5 seconds more than what was recorded. So explain how the mean would have been affected by this error. Yeah, so the actual values should have been 5 seconds less, right? So since they added 5 seconds to everybody, how did that change the original? So from the original, we increased by 5. The mean increased by 5. Standard deviation, unchanged. Because the spread is still the same. The shape of the distribution still looks the same. So much space. Find the minimum top amount of money it needs to top up. 1.65. Anybody needs me to go through? Yes, sir. Okay. So we have the parking rates for cars at Vivo City. This person drove for a movie on Saturday. So everything else, I don't care really. He parked from 3:30 to 7:40. There's a balance of 5:35 as he entered, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so he entered at 3:30. That is before 6 o'clock, right? So how much does he need to pay? First hour, he needs to pay $1.40. So from 3:30 to 4:30, he pays $1.40. What? 4:30 to 6 p.m. Because the charges for this subsequent 30 minutes is until 6 p.m. only. So I need to consider from 4:30 to 6 p.m. How many half an hours are there? Yes. Okay, hang on. Yeah. So what are you trying to say? No, this is how it works. This is how they are going to charge you in reality. In reality, they are going to charge you based on this one first. Your charges from whatever time you go in until 6 p.m., they charge you one amount. After that, they charge you another amount, which is the after 6 o'clock timing. Yeah, good money, right? But then it depends. If you are going to park there for a long, long time, then it's okay lor. You'd rather be charged one time, 350 at 6 o'clock, rather than they still keep adding and adding and adding. So you need to strategize next time. Next time you want to drive, right? Strategize, go and check out the parking rate so that you get your things done, but you pay the least amount of money. Huh? Okay? So this is... You pray that the MRT don't break down. Okay? So for this one, he pays 4:30 to 6 p.m. How many half an hours are there? There are three of them. 3 times 0.70. Then from 6 p.m. to 7:40 p.m., he pays 3:50. So total, this will be $7. This is the amount he needs to pay. And since he has $3.35, then he needs to top up. Yep, 7 minus 5.35 equals to 1.65. Okay? So if you are this person, what time do you want to get out? Yeah, you want to get out at 5:59. Quickly go out so they don't charge you again. But if you want to stay there for a long time, then you go after 6 lah. Okay? Okay, moving on. Question 25. 10 million. This is 10 power 7. This is 1660000. You all get this? Got it? No, didn't. Okay. I suspected so. Okay, so an increase in value by 220%. What are we comparing this 220% to? 500,000. We are comparing it to 500,000. This was the original. So this is my 100%. Okay, this is my 100%. Then it increased by 220%. So how much is it worth now? It's worth 320% now. So it is worth value in 2010 is 320% of what? Original, $500,000. And that should give you 1660000, yes or no? Noah. Yeah. Oh, 1 6. Really? Hey, wait, let me calculate. 700,000. Okay, this is 1600000. We are increased in value by 100%, 200%. Yeah, 320/100 × 700,000. So correct, right? Like this, right? So the answer should be 1.6 million. Right. So correct, huh? Yeah, my. Sorry, the answer key showed otherwise. Okay. Now question 26. Chargeable income is total income for the year minus tax relief. Okay, what does this mean? You know, next time you all work, you earn money, right? Then what will the government do? They will tax you. This one is recorded, so I must be very careful with what I say. They will tax you so that the money can be used to benefit Singaporeans for roads, for the everything like maintenance, okay? For many, many different things. So, tax. Now, as you earn money, do you want them to tax you a lot or tax you a little bit? Yeah, you want them to tax you just a little bit, right? Unless you are very generous. You want to contribute to Singapore, they tax you a lot. But reality, probably nobody does that. So you want them to tax you a little bit only. Do you think they will tax your entire salary? So suppose you earn $1,000 a month. So after 12 months, you earn $12,000, right? Would it tax you based on the $12,000? You think that they may, but actually they give you benefits. They give you things like tax relief. Okay, what is this tax relief? Maybe you have a kid. Maybe you have children. They encourage you to have children, right? So if you have children, they tell you, okay, your tax relief is $2,000. So what does that mean? Instead of taxing your $12,000, they tax you based on $12,000 minus $2,000. So even better, right? They tax you based on $10,000 only. Good deal for you, isn't it? So we, as taxpayers, we want to have as much tax relief as possible. So maybe you donate money. Then they say, okay, you donate this amount of money, I don't tax you for that. So in this case, this Mrs. Day, she earns $4,000 a month. In 1 year, how much does she earn? Okay, in 1 year, she earns annual salary is equals to 4,000 times 12, that is $48,000. This is total income for the year. Okay, it's over here, $48,000. And then she has a tax relief of $11,800 for the year. What she did, I don't know, maybe she went to give birth, maybe she went to donate money, she took care of parents, whatever not. Government say, okay, good job, I deduct $11,800 from your total income. So now government will charge you based on your chargeable income. Okay, this one over here is $11,800. So of course, you want them to tax you as little as possible, but for you, for them to do that, you must do something that they like, which in this case is give birth or something. So chargeable income for the year, this will be 48,000 minus 11,800. And that will be $36,200. Okay, so now, they are going to tax her based on this amount of money. It's a better deal than taxing her based on $48,000. But it is not so simple also. They don't just say, oh, I tax you 10%. They actually tax $350 on the first $30,000 of chargeable income. So right now, I'm only interested in this value. I'm only interested in this value. I don't care about my $48,000. I don't care about my $11,800 anymore. Only interested in $36,200. That is my chargeable income. And how do they pay, how do they charge? For the first $30,000, you have to pay $350. For the subsequent amount, you pay 5.5%. So this, the $36,200 is equals to $30,000 plus $6,200, right? And they charge the tax as equals to, for the first $30,000, how much do they charge? $350 plus the remainder, 5.5% times $6,200. Yes? Ooh, okay. Thank you. So over here we have a total of $691. Okay? I didn't calculate it, but if you did, it should be the same. Okay. So that's it. The graph not clear. For your paper. Okay, yeah, you're right. You cannot read. The fixed charge is 16. So over here is 16. It's very difficult to read from your paper. Then the cost per minute is $0.40. Okay. Free talk time. Oh, because they are already charging, right? They are charging 16, right? Yeah, so not very honest of them to say free talk time lah. After the fixed price talk time, okay? So it increases at 40 cents per minute. How to calculate 40 cents? Okay, we need to find convenient points. So after 20 minutes, increase by so much. Okay, this, let's use this point. Oh, how about this one? This one more convenient. This point over here. Can you find any more convenient points? Okay, let me use this point. So at 80 minutes used, after 20 minutes, so total of 40 minutes. Okay, for this 40 minutes, how much more did she have to pay? Oh, sorry. My already, the eyes not very good. So 60 minutes, then the amount over here is 40 minus 16, right? This is 24. So for 60 minutes, she has to pay an extra of $24. So 1 minute, she will have to pay. So 60 minute, pay $24. 1 minute pay, 24 divided by 60. Is that really 40 cents? Yeah. Okay, lah. 40 cents. Now, plan B. It has charges as follows: $15 fixed charge plus 25 cents for each minute. So they want you to draw, right? Yeah, draw a graph. So I know that it is very difficult for you to read your graph. They didn't even manage to print out all the grids. So just look at the way it should be done. Okay, let me use purple. So $15. Fixed charge plus 25 cents per minute. It starts over here. $15. Then for every minute, it costs 25 cents. So after 20 minutes, how much will it cost? 20 times 25 cents. That is $5. So from here, we will increase by $5 until this point. So for every 20 minutes, we'll increase by $5. To this point, another 20 minutes, another $5. Okay. Then we join it up with one straight line. Okay, this is for plan B. Use your graph to find the difference in price between A and B for a call of 20 minutes. So we find out where is the 20 minutes. Okay, it's over here. How much does it cost for A? A still costs 16, while B costs 20. So the difference is 20 minus 16, and you get 4. Okay, find the range of minutes for which B is cheaper than A. So where in this graph do we have the purple graph under the black graph? So around this region. And this region is approximately after 46 minutes. So as long as you talk for more than 46 minutes, plan B is a better deal. If you talk less than 40, if you talk between 4 minutes to 46 minutes, then plan A is a better deal. So they ask for a range. You leave your answer as an inequality, T more than 46 minutes. We cannot include T more than equals to, because when it is equals to 46 minutes, it is not cheaper. They are the same price. Now, question 28. show that it's a right angle triangle. Do you remember the steps? Okay, we write down AC, we can choose to write down AC square first. That is equals to 41 square. And that is 1681. Then I write down AB square plus BC square. Am I saying that it is already equals to AC square? No, I cannot say that because it is not a right angle triangle. It's not proven yet. So right now I'm testing it out. AB square plus BC square is 40 square plus 9 square. Calculate it. Now there you see that A is also 1681. What a coincidence. So we conclude that since, we can continue over here. This is equals to AC square, right? We got this from the earlier step. So since AB square plus BC square equals to AC square, then triangle ABC is a right angle triangle. Okay. By the converse of Pythagoras' theorem, you need to spell it out. I don't know how to spell. Triangle. Then too bad lah. I'm not sitting for exam. Triangle ABC is a right angle triangle. Okay. So now, find without using a calculator, cosine ACD. Cosine ACD, trigo. Using our trigo ratio, what is cosine supposed to be equals to? Cosine theta equals to adjacent over the hypotenuse, right? But this is only useful if you have a right angle triangle. Now, this is my angle, ACD. Is there a right angle triangle here? Don't have. So I need to use the relationship between cosine theta equals to negative cosine 180 degrees minus theta. I need to use this. Okay? Now, the question wants, so similarly, cosine 180 degrees minus theta is equals to negative cosine theta, like it's the same thing. Okay? Since I want cosine of this angle, I can call this theta. Then this is 180 degrees minus theta, right? Cosine 180 degrees minus theta is equals to negative cosine theta. Cosine theta, what is this? Adjacent, which is 9 over hypotenuse 41. So answer is negative 9 over 41. And finally, tangent of 90 degrees minus ACB. ACB. What is 90 minus ACB? Yeah, this angle over here. This angle is 90 degrees minus angle ACB. Why? Because of angle sum of triangle. All of them add up to be 180 degrees, and we know that this is 90 degrees already. So tangent of this angle is opposite over adjacent, 9 over 40. Okay, question 29, 40 cm, 6.37, 143.2 degrees. Need help? All okay? And now okay? You sure okay? Question 30A. Height equals to 3. B part 1. Height equals to negative 85. Oh, over here this is a cliff, right? This is 0. Then you throw up. Then maybe you reach here. This is 5 meters. Then it drops down. Drop down to 0, right? Then you continue to drop some more. Negative? Yes, this is how it works. then it is 85 meters below the cliff. Then part C, what did y'all get? Okay, then part C. This is what is happening, huh? At the cliff, the first ball is thrown. Then, 4 seconds after the first ball is thrown, she throws a second ball in the same way. Then they're asking you for 1 second after the second ball is thrown. Meaning, how long has the first ball been thrown already? 5 seconds. So where is the first ball after 5 seconds? Yeah, at time equals to 5 seconds, the first ball is over here. First ball. The distance over here is 85 meters. And at time equals to 5 seconds, how long has the second ball been thrown for? It's been thrown for only 1 second. So where is the second ball after 1 second it's been thrown? So at time equals to 1, the distance traveled should have been 3, right? So the second ball is probably over here, and the height is 3 meters. This is the second ball. Can you understand what's happening? So what's the distance between them? Equals to 88 plus, sorry, 85. Plus 3 equals to 88. Or we can do it this way. Distance equals to 3 minus negative 85 equals to 88 still. Method 1 is using distance. Method 2 uses the concept of displacement. Okay, finishing ready. 7. Then 1, 5, 7, and 46.9. Need me to go through any part? Anybody? Colin, do you see the answers already? Got it correct? Okay, then last part. Final question. What is wrong with the way that she collected the data? Never put hours. Okay, that was an error in the question. There is missing information. Let me see what it is first. Okay, from my memory, the question should have been something like this. 1 to 2 hours. Sorry? You have the same question. Where? Can you show me? It's near the TOS. Can you show me the TOS? Or wherever you all saw this question? Okay, thank you. Okay, so this over here is, exactly the same question. 1 to 2, 3 to 4, 5 to 7, and over 7. Okay, what's wrong with this? Fill in this information first. It should have been part of your question. 2 to 3 don't have. Yeah, what happens if a person exercises for 2.5 hours? When he tick? In between, tick here. So, okay, but before that, what is wrong with the way that she collected the data? If you want to survey Singaporeans, if you want to survey the Singaporeans on how many hours they spend in the gym, yeah, then it is quite biased, right, if you stand outside the gym to survey people who go to the gym, the number of hours they spend at the gym. Because if you want it to be fair, we should ask every Singaporean. But it is not possible. So we randomly choose people to ask. But did she randomly choose people? No, she stood outside the gym. Of course the people there are going to be exercising for long hours. Okay, so that's the That is what is wrong with the way she collected the data. She surveyed people outside the gym. Data collected is, what is the word we should use?
Bias,
yes. So in order to be fair, we need to survey people randomly. McDonald's also probably not a very good choice. Okay, whatever. You all know what I mean. Okay, what is wrong with the way she collected with the survey question? So you all said that. What about people who exercise for 2.5 hours? Yep. Yeah, what about people who don't exercise at all? Yes. So the intervals do not include zero value. Then what else? The data collected is time, which is a continuous data, which is continuous data. Do you understand what does continuous data mean? That sounds like discrete to me. So the opposite of continuous is discrete. Discrete is one by one. So hour one, hour two, hour three. Continuous means that you cannot break it up. You can zoom in and zoom in and zoom in, there will still be a time over there. So it's continuous, there's no break. Okay? So the intervals, exactly, she didn't make it continuous. It should have been continuous, right? The intervals should have been zero, then x, maybe one, then one, x, two, so on and so forth. Make sense? Okay, so that's all for this paper.